Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video book review on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and today we're reviewing my book, Chassepot to FAMAS, French Military Rifles, 1866 to 2016. Some people might think to themselves, say, Ian, isn't it a blatant conflict of interest to review a book that you wrote yourself? And my answer would be, I don't really care. When you write your own book, you're welcome to review it or not as you see fit. I am super excited about this to finally be able to formally introduce it to you now that we actually have it shipping. We had a little bit of a drawn out printing process, unfortunately, but the final product is gorgeous and I think you'll really love it. So I have to kind of cover a specific set of different topics here, lest I just meabber on for like an hour about this thing because it is my baby and I am very proud of it. So first off, why did I write this thing? And the answer is, when I started about 3 years ago, I was very interested in French rifles. I was collecting French rifles myself, and there was basically no good reference work in English. We have a number of good books on French pistols that have been published. We have one collector-grade book on French semi-auto rifles, and that is Proud Promise by Jean Yuan. It's a great book. I highly recommend it if you don't have a copy. But it covers about two chapters worth of what I have in this book, which is, by the way, 10 chapters. So that leaves 80% of this material that just wasn't out there. If you wanted a reference book on the Berthier or a reference book on the FAMAS, there are books in French, but there was really nothing in English. So I figured, what the heck, I'll write it myself. And I did. Now the scope of the book. This covers specifically rifles that were designed and manufactured in France and used by the French military. So there are a variety of foreign-made rifles that the French military used. In World War I, they used Remington rolling blocks. They used Winchester lever-action rifles. During the Cold War, there were elements of the French army that had Sig-Marmion, like SG-540 series rifles. Those are not included in the scope of this book, with the sole exception of the 1878 Marine Kropatschek. So I have 10 chapters in here. This comes to a total of just over 530 pages, which is awesome. It's huge. The 10 chapters are the Chassepot, the Gras, the Kropatschek family of rifles, the Lebel, the Berthier, the RSC semi-autos, the MAS 36, the MAS semi-auto series, which would be from the MAS 40 through the MAS 4956, the FR pattern sniper rifles, FRF1, F2, primarily, and the FAMAS assault rifle. So that is the scope of the book. In every one of those chapters, I look at a variety of different pieces of information. We have an overview describing where the rifle came from, how it came about, why it was developed, what the intention was. And by the way, that's a section that we expanded, or I expanded, with the help of a couple editors, in every chapter after we did the pre-sale. When we realized how big of a pre-sale we had, we realized that a lot of the people getting this book were not going to be devoted French rifle collectors. There just aren't that many of you guys out there. And what we had was a lot of people who were interested in like the Forgotten Weapons take on the story of these specific rifle patterns. And so we expanded the content, the coverage, kind of the base work, the foundational context for each rifle. Anyway, beyond that, we'll look at production, how many of them were made, the different variations of each family that were made, including serial number tables. So I have date and number tables for almost every pattern of rifle in here, which is, I think, a fantastic resource. And by the way, I am indebted to a French researcher friend who was willing to let me use a bunch of his serial number tables that he's been putting together for many years. So you guys benefit from many, many years of his work putting those together. And I think it's a great addition to the resource, and I'm much indebted to him. Thank you if you're watching this. Anyway, cover the production, the variations, the actual military use of the guns, like where were they used, when were they used, to what extent were they used. Disassembly. We have a section at the back of the book, actually, we turned it into an appendix on disassembly of each of the patterns of rifles. So if you have these and you don't know how to take them apart, I will tell you how. And then also the mechanics of how each one of these rifles works. Predominantly comes into play in the semi-auto rifles, where there are complex mechanical systems involved. So 10 chapters with all of that information. We have a number of appendices in there covering things like a list of French inspectors whose initials and marks show up on the guns, a nice table of French script serial number prefix letters, because that's how they numbered these things. They had letter prefixes that are written in a French script that can be kind of difficult to interpret if you're not familiar with what you're looking at. So we have a table of the different letters that you will encounter there. My goal in writing this was to create a reference guide that would allow you to adequately identify any French rifle that you actually came across in real life. So predominantly aimed at collectors and historians who are looking at guns that were used in various military conflicts, or guns that they were looking to add to a personal collection. Anything you might encounter at a gun show or an auction, or generally speaking, even a museum. I didn't try to cover prototypes and experimental rifles. This is more of a practical guide. It's the sort of thing that I would love to see people take to gun shows and use as a reference book on the fly. We kind of designed the physical size of the book for that. The fact that it will open completely flat. You can very easily hold it in one hand without the pages flipping back and forth. There's some little details like that that I'm really happy about that we have worked into the book technically. So anything you run into, I want you to be able to identify what it was, where did it come from, when was it made, to a lesser extent, is this authentic? Or not so much, maybe is it authentic, but has this been reworked? This M16 Berthier, is it a World War I pattern gun, a World War II pattern gun? Where did it come from? Some of these rifles were in service for many decades and underwent a series of changes over that time. And I want this book to be able to unlock all of those questions. And I think, if again, I'm not going to be too arrogant to say so, I think I did a pretty darn good job of it. And I think the book will do that quite well. On another sort of technical note, I do want to call out the photography that we did. James Rupley did almost all of the photography in this book, every gun that we were able to get our hands on firsthand. There are a few guns in there that we got pictures sent to us from other people for particularly rare models that we weren't able to source directly. But James's photography is absolutely phenomenal. And I don't think it's too much to say that the photography in this book is absolutely the best that you will find in any technical firearms reference book that has ever been published to date. It looks gorgeous. Not only is it just really nice to browse through and look at because of that photography, it also means that all sorts of little tiny details in the guns are very easily visible. This is not one of those books that's full of overly dark, blurry, black and white pictures of different guns. Everything in here, with the exception of a small number of original vintage photos of World War I and World War II, every photo in here is full color and looks great. You'll see a little bit of that in the B-roll here, but you, to a certain extent, you really just have to put your hands on the book and look at it to see that. So, speaking of which, should you want to do that, the book is available through Headstamp Publishing at headstamppublishing.com, or short-linked by going to frenchriflebook.com. I'll have a link in the description text below. It is available only directly through our website there. Standard cover price is $95. There's also a hand-signed edition if you would like that, which, by the way, is hand-signed. I spent, if you didn't see it, a substantial amount of time hand-signing books, so you can get in on that if you want. I'm very excited about this. I think it'll be a great resource for people interested in French rifles, and this is only the beginning. We have big plans for Headstamp Publishing. We have a number of other books already in the pipeline. As of this moment of recording, we have two manuscripts that are almost completely done that we're very excited to bring to you in the near future. So, thanks for watching. Check out my book, and I'll catch you next time.